he's still young, but he's an established player out here in MD. So these guys definitely don't want to lose to each other, and they just want to prove themselves to each other, even though they're both very strong players. It's just who's stronger.
And I guess, you know, Rax is like, well, have you gotten top eight at a national? That's feeling himself a bit more. And right now, DD, though, with those beautiful punishes, his reactions are amazing. He's immediately up-tilting Bayonetta once she tries to hill slide through. Making it work for Rags. You know, they are scrapping, throws out that back air. Rags not going to try to go for a state spike or anything like that. Got the down tilt, not able, though, to make anything else happen afterwards.
I love how Rags, like, sometimes players have different combo trees when they don't main that character. And Rags, he'll just go straight for the side B, and it's actually really good because it covers so many drifts in the air.
Definitely a good point. DD off the stage, what edge guard is Rags can go for. Down air a little early, covers afterwards though with the down tilt. Goes for the back air. DD does get that tech, he is known for it. And the roles have reversed. DD right now having stage control, but definitely down the percent. But again, back off stage, gonna try to recover that down tilt, not gonna do it this time. Rags immediately grabbing after, forward though, not quite. But again, DD's gonna have to recover. Ooh. And he manages to do it when it's all said and done.
Nice.
And he kills off it instead. Talk about the turn of events. The reversal right there was crazy from ZD.
Yeah, ZD was on the defensive for like the last 20 seconds, and that's what you're used to in the matchup. Like, edge guard, getting through Bayonetta's edge guards is one of the hardest things to do in this matchup. But doing that, especially if you expend a lot of aerials or aerial specials to get you there, it can get you a lot. So that's more of an incentive to actually try and make it back. But Rags, though, still keeping himself in it. He just runs straight up and grabs him, and that's going to be an even game for these players right now.
It is, and this is why it's a treat. These players have been scrapping. Two stocks have been gone. We're averaging the stock a minute at the moment. Rags getting that jab and a bit of damage. Beautiful grab coming in. ZD hits the ground, but only for a moment because Rags is just all over him. One thing that Rags is doing that is just so great is he refreshes the situation that gives him the advantage. Whether it's putting ZD back off stage or whether it's putting ZD back in the air, he just seems like he's so good at it.
I feel like that comes from playing Meta Knight, a character who like can kill you super early but has to expend like a lot of space to do so. So he's not getting power drunk, you know? Like, he's not going, oh, hey, I'm in an advantageous situation. Let me just keep on doing it. ZD, on the other hand, he's like, well, why won't I up here? Why won't I keep up here?
Yeah.
Stop
and,
me.
And Rags is one of the Bayonettas that does not witch time too often. Obviously, he can do it, and he's not known for his combos quite yet, so it might not be quite as risky. But I'm sure ZD kind of honed in on that and said, hey, let me keep up the onslaught because you haven't witch time yet. Why would you start now?
Exactly. And this is a best of five set, so I don't blame Rags for not going for it just yet, because that stuff definitely wins you games, like especially games 4 and 5. But you have to get there first, and like if you don't get there, then whatever witch time you don't do, don't matter, if that makes sense.
Currently, Bayonetta not panning out for Rags quite yet, and it's looking even worse now, 85 to 32. ZD having his way. That F smash does not connect. Reads the air dodge, but he didn't go for an up air. He actually went for a forward air that did not connect. Rags still having a chance to draw first blood at the moment, but he's going to have to do it quick. And again, speaking of quick, the reactions from ZD are phenomenal. Talk about always punishing a tech roll situation.
Yeah, he loves doing that. Whenever he hits tech, sometimes if you're a good player, he'll just stand there and wait. And every good player techs it at least once. And ZD has her extra time to back that up. And look at that. He's still keeping the pressure going. Dash attack, not forcing tech situations, so Rags will actually get out of that. But you know what? We'll lock you and we'll drop you. But
wow.
You're still up. So, got a little bit hype. But that was a great setup. It's rare that you see Nair Jablon off of that scenario.
I'm just speechless right now. ZD is running away with this. But Rags is still indeed Bayonetta, and we've seen crazier comebacks. Gets the witch time. Rinse, repeat. What's he going to do after?
Tech.
We see the tech. We see the tech. He tech dropped down. That was genius right there by ZD. Instead of going into a situation where back air would have connected, Rags did not know what to do. And right now, ZD is up 2-0 right now with a 2-stock.
Yeah, and actually, the way that you tech that, a back air couldn't have connected with the position that Rags was in. You're invincible. Wait, do they know? Yo, this is best of five.
If they don't know, I will make sure they know. Hold on one moment.
One sec. Okay. I lied. It was best of three. One sec. Huh.
Apparently, ZD said no. Raffle said it's best of three.